Across Yorkshire's moors and dales, the world's most famous vet set the benchmark for animal care. And James Herriot's legacy lives on. His former trainee, Peter Wright, has been a Yorkshire vet for over 40 years.
James Herriot used to take me out feeding cows. We used to get finished and pop in and have a cup of tea. Lovely.
Peter's old partner, Julian Norton,
with your big ears and your big attitude,
now runs two practices.
I get my wellies on and then we'll jump to action.
One of them in the North Yorkshire town where Herriot lived and worked.
There we go. We're going to have some fun.
And in the foothills of the Pennines.
Give it a wellie, that's it.
A new generation of town and country vets.
Catch Dave.
Also uphold the Herriot ethos.
You get some of that, lad. What a champion, eh?
Come on, vets.
The teams are united.
It's brilliant, isn't it?
It is.
And driven by one common goal.
Oh, it's massive.
To help animals of all shapes.
Why are we so bad at catching monkeys?
Sizes.
Blimey.
They are the smallest testicles I've ever removed from a pony.
Types.
Oh, fuck.
And temperaments.
Yep.
It's definitely not glamorous.
It's a bit grim.
But it's varied.
Hello?
Hello!
Game of football after dinner.
It's rarely easy.
Piggly, come on.
But they continue the Herriot tradition.
They're bombing these Leicester lambs, aren't they?
Treating all creatures.
We?
Great.
We've got pals.
You're all right, Cliff.
And small.
Oh.
The romantic poet John Keats wrote that a thing of beauty is a joy forever, that its loveliness increases. And his words certainly ring true in Yorkshire. But Keats also compared life to a fragile dewdrop on its perilous way from a tree's summit. While Peter doesn't claim to be a poet, he's well versed in the fragility of life. And tonight he's working late at the practice after a call from a worried farmer.
Abby's rung up and said she's having problems with one of the shearlings, that's one of the female ewes that's having difficulty lambing. She's been scanned already in the early stage of pregnancy and she's got three babies in there. I think let's get organised properly. We'll have her out if we can.
Yeah.
She hasn't progressed with lambing as she should have done, so Abby's concerned, so we're going to have a look inside now and see if we can see what's happening.
I noticed her back end was going a bit stiff and her colour in her water bag wasn't quite right. And I thought, something's not right here.
She's not opened up as well as she should do.
Ah.
Mm. She's not opened at all. Not well at all. She's literally like that. Will she be about on time, Abby?
She's due 21st.
So a couple of weeks.
Yeah.
Mm.
But when she walks, she's tight in the back end, so...
Yeah. The cervix is tight shut there. You can't even get your finger in. It's
yeah.
That tight. And when you're getting that stuff out, it means the afterbirths are starting to separate now, and lambs will only live for so long
yeah.
in that state. If they die off inside, they're going to make her toxic and we're going to lose her.
Yeah.
But they aren't going to come out. Not
no.
a chance. So our only option to try and save the lambs and her as well in the longer term is to do a cesarean.
Yeah.
So yeah. we'll crack on, shall we?
Yeah. yeah.
Right.
We'll just have to see what Peter can do. Because I'd be heartbroken without my little sheep. But hope for the best.
Right. Abby, I don't know whether you want to come to a head end and
yeah.
just help support her a bit there. And then you can say nice things to her.
Yeah. Good girl.
It's a cold night, a bit of frost, and this is my first lambing of the year. With lambing time, I think they always get the problems over, really, at the start. I'm just worried with these being 2 weeks before the time. That worries me.
Yeah.
But we have no choice. If we don't do something, it's just going to be a disaster.
We'll lose out,
we will. We will. If we're lucky, we may have one alive, we may have two alive, and if we're very lucky, we might have all three alive, but it's got to hope. Her tummy's quite bloated, so I've got to be a little bit careful because sitting just directly under here are the abdominal organs. So I've just got to proceed with great caution. Right. Quite a lot of fluid in there. Very distended, this lamb bed. Not good. Not good at all.
In the heart of glorious North Yorkshire lies the quaint market town of Thirsk. And a vet who worked here at the original Heriot practice for 21 years, Julian Norton, is about to open a brand new surgery with his wife Anne.
Come on, we're going in. She knows where to go, look.
After a 2 month renovation project.
We're here, aren't we?
Yeah, we're here. Nearly ready to open. It's been quite a stressful week this week, turning it into a workplace. There's many more things to consider than you first think. Orders arriving and things being missing and nothing being quite as straightforward as it should have been, but we're nearly there now.
Shall we practice? Let's practice with Emmy. When I take the dog for a walk, it used to take 20 minutes. Now it takes about an hour because people keep stopping and saying, oh, when's your new practice opening? Veterinary, my dog's poorly.
Oh, no, Emmy.
There she is.
Oh, no.
There's something not right with her. And I'm not right sure what.
It's because she's got no teeth, look.
That's it. Is it how you imagined it to be?
Yeah, it has turned out exactly how I imagined it was going to, actually.
I can't imagine how it could be any better, really.
No, it's really good.
We think we've got pretty much everything. We've not got syringes or needles.
No, we're waiting for the big order of all the stuff like cotton wool and all that sort of thing, which is a slightly vulnerable feeling, having no bits.
Bandages?
Yeah, all that. No, we haven't got them yet. They're all coming today, hopefully.
So work here should begin soon, once they've crossed the T's.
It feels good.
And dotted the I.
Feels really good, except they've missed a dot off my eye. But anyway, I've fixed that with some Tippex. And there we are.
We have worked in the same practice before, but we didn't have nameplates, I don't think, did we?
We've never been adjacent on a nameplate.
No.
It's exciting times.
Coming up...
I'm concerned that things may not go so well here.
Peter and Abby battle to save the lambs.
Where there's life, there's hope. We'll work at them.
What have you got for us today?
Well, I think a twisted stomach.
Will there be a twist in the tail for Shona?
Oh, it's huge. Oh, it's massive.
And problems.
Lids.
Oh, no.
At the new practice.
We've got
bottles. We've got bottles, but no lids.
On there.
At the practice in Kirby Moorside, Peter's not feeling optimistic.
I'm concerned that things may not go so well here.
He's performing an emergency C-section to try and save a ewe and her three premature babies.
I'm going to make our incision there now.
After farmer Abby made the tough decision to bring in Mum, knowing her lambs weren't due for another 2 weeks.
I left her a bit.
Yeah.
And then I thought, I can't leave her. I'll have to do something. At least I can try and save her.
Exactly. Mm. Come on. There's a little bit of life there.
Vet student Fiona is on hand to help Abby with the struggling newborns.
Have a go at that fella as well.
Come on, little man.
One left. Come on, don't be shy. Very little.
Yep.
Where there's life, there's hope. We'll work at him. Where there's life, there's hope.
Come on, little one.
I've got to concentrate on what the mother's doing now. Fiona, if we do with your assistance. Right, let's get her stitched up. How are we doing, Abby?
You're still going.
Still going?
Yep, that first one is.
Good.
Come on, you. He's going really well. This one's taking a bit of going, and this one we can feel a heartbeat, but we're not too sure about him. Has its heart stopped now? Yeah.
I'm not surprised, Abby, to be honest. They've had all the hard work, really, trying to revive these lambs, and I'm amazed that they've got as far as they have with them. If we end up with one live lamb, then the operation's been worth it, as far as I'm concerned. Massively worth it. And if someone's kind to us up there, we may save two lambs.
Is she doing all right, Peter?
Yes, she's fine. Final stitch. Are you up?
Yes.
That's impressive. Right, Mrs. Let's get these ropes off you. Have a look at them, Mrs. Have a look with yours. Do you want to give her that into her thigh? Can you manage that? Lovely. We'll give them a bit of antibiotic anyway, which will protect it as well.
Yeah.
Right, shall we try and get her in? Come on, then. Ready? Is the heater on it front, Ben?
Yeah.
Don't want to be in somewhere warm now.
Back home, I'll make sure they both get their colostrum, and I might put them under a heat lamp just because it's a cold night now.
Lovely. Excellent.
Without Peter, I think I'd have lost everything. He's a good lad, is Peter.
Right, let's keep everything crossed now.
Yeah. Yeah, thank you.
Thank you. Let me know, are you going on?
Yeah.
I've done my best for Abby, and I've done my best for the ewe, and I'm just hopeful that things will go OK now.
Farming is one of the world's oldest professions. And a Yorkshire farmer's livelihood has always depended on looking after their animals and keeping them healthy.
Mom.
But times do change.
Good girl.
In James Herriot's day, everything was done by hand. Now, dairy farmers like James Hill rely on modern technology, not only for production, but to make sure there are no health problems in the herd.
We've had the robots in now 3.5 years. The robots give us a hell of a lot of information, from weighing them every time they come in. We've got the rumination, so how many minutes they're chewing the cud, the activity, so how much they're walking around the shed. So we've got a very good picture every day of what every cow is doing.
And one of the clever computerized cow collars has told James that one of his girls might be unwell.
The robot actually weighs the cow, and she's actually lost 100 kilograms of weight, so we know there's definitely a problem. She's not eating any of the cake that we give to them. I've not noticed her eat any silage from around the outside of the shed either. Go on, love. Good girl. Good lass. Come on, then. I'd probably think it's going to be a twisted stomach. It'd be really bad. Obviously, like humans, if they're not eating, they're not getting any energy, they can't sustain themselves, let alone give any milk, so it's paramount we try and get something in her and get her ruminating again. Oh, love, you're all right. Go on.
Shona's just arrived from the Huddersfield Animal Hospital.
Hello, how are you both doing?
All right, I think.
Yeah. What have you got for us today?
Well, I think a twisted stomach. I'm hoping not, but okay. Yeah. I did observe her yesterday.
Right.
She came in the robot late last night and she didn't even sniff a cake.
I'll get another look over.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Grand.
Now then, lass.
Sorry, love.
Good girl. She's a bit sunk in her eyes,
yeah,
isn't she? Good girl.
You're all right, love.
You can see her stomach's not turning over. It's not even lifting my hand.
Yeah.
It sounds a bit too sort of gassy, and it's not cycling like it normally should. So that confirms what the computer was saying, that she isn't ruminating, which is when the rumen is churning food. If they go off their food, they end up producing a lot of gases in one of the stomachs called the abomasum, and that stomach swings round and then sits in the wrong position. They can become very unwell and they can die from it as well. It's definitely a twisted stomach.
Yeah.
It's mapping out sort of this kind of area, so I think it's quite a big one. The sooner we can operate, the better.
That's right. Right. Better get going.
Yeah.
This is often a two-vet job, but Shona's planning to go it alone.
I am hoping that we can do this from this side and pull it round. So I'm going to put plenty of local anaesthetic in so she can't feel what's going on and doesn't get upset. Oh, it's huge. Oh, it's massive. So the abomasum should be on the bottom at the middle of the cow. It's all the way up on that side. It's practically touching her back. So at the minute, it's a big balloon full of air stuck on the other side of the abdomen. There's a lot of other structures for it to get past. It's really in a bad place.
In Thirsk...
Are you coming in, Em?
Julian and Anne are ready to start work at their new practice. Almost.
It's all been pretty plain sailing, I suppose, it's fair to say.
Well, plain sailing, as long as our syringes and things arrive today.
And cotton wool, I'm worried about. How can we work without cotton wool?
Unless the cotton wool appears, then we've... And needles.
And finally, the all-important delivery has arrived.
Brilliant, in you come.
OMS is here.
This is excellent. This is the final piece of the veterinary jigsaw. How many cotton buds do we need? Three boxes of cotton buds.
Surgical spirit.
Suture needles. 11 packets. Why do we need 11 packets?
Well, they're all the different sizes of needles. Oh, this is going to be a nightmare because there's, like, loads.
It's going to be complicated, this. I'll get India.
So we've got surgical drape.
OK.
There's more needles than we know what to do with. Who's ordered all these?
Well, do you know how many needles you need to have to start practice? This is lube.
Lube? How much lube have we got? Whoa! Excellent. That's going to make a good evening. Ah, look at that.
Lids. Oh, no.
We've got bottles,
but no lids.
But no lids.
Plastic bottles uncapped.
Bother. How long do you think this will last?
I don't know. Depends how busy we are.
And apart from a few lids, there is just one element missing at Thirsk's new veterinary practice.
This is the, kennels, which I have to say, I think this is my favourite part of the practice. Dogs, big dog, cats in their own special room. It's pretty much bob on, I would say.
Bob on?
Bob on.
Who says that?
Bob on, I've not heard that. Something's totally perfect, it's bob on. First patients arriving imminently. It really will be a vet's when we've got some animals in it.
Coming up, the ups and downs of lambing season.
A lamb's just been born. Watching the lambs spring about, it just puts a smile on your face.
Doesn't it? It's a magical time.
Shona wants to call for help.
I need yellow pages, I'm a little bit small for this girl.
And the time for role-play consultations is over. The new practice's next delivery will be life and death.
I'm supposed to have some babies, but nothing's happening.
But will there be teething problems?
So where is everything?
At James's dairy farm.
This needed operating on sooner rather than later.
Shona's in the middle of life-saving surgery, trying to fix a cow's badly twisted stomach.
When the abomasum and this stomach that can twist, when it moves, they produce a lot of gas. The gas in there will feel uncomfortable because that triggers the nerves to feel sore, and that's partly why they look so miserable.
James was alerted to his cow's problem by her high-tech collar.
To see her suddenly just decline as fast as she had, yeah, it was a very noticeable change.
So this is the needle and tube that we use. This is to empty the gas out of the stomach. It's a stonking big needle. That's because I want it as wide as possible to let all the gas out. It looks horrible, but she won't feel it. So let's go for it. I'm going past her left kidney. I don't want to stick a needle in that. And I'm going next to her big stomach as well to reach the little stomach, which is the abomasum. So I don't want to damage anything else on the way in. That's just what makes this bit a little bit tricky.
Yeah.
So I'm listening to it, I can hear the gas coming out. It's a nasty one, this. I'm getting a lot of fluid as well as the gas coming out. I'm going to bring this needle out now and we're going to have a go at pulling the stomach round. It feels nice and saggy and floppy now, which is what I want. So I'm going between her liver, in front of her rumen and the main stomach. There's lots of structures down here. I need yellow pages, I'm a little bit small for this girl. Did we get a standing block, James? Did you find a milk crate or anything to stand on?
If it goes on its side, it might be.
Oh, yeah. I think I've got the right bit, but I just want to stand on a crate. So it's just a matter of pulling without tearing anything, really. Right, that's brilliant. So this is the bit that we want. The aim of the game now is I need this stomach to stay on this side of the abdomen. I don't want it going back over on the left-hand side. So I'm going to do that by stitching it to the muscle on this side of the abdomen.
I think that's gone pretty well up to now. So the fact that you haven't had to go in through the other side, I've been here before where there's been two vets shaking hands through the middle of the cow pretty much. So the fact we've only had to open one side, it's less risk of infection and just monitor what she's eating going forward now, can't we?
Yeah, well, you can because you've got a fancy collar to do it for you. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, I'll let you know when a rumination hits 100. We're going the right way.
Yeah, that'll be brilliant. Job done, all sprayed up. The guys are going to give her a big drink. But she is looking a lot happier already. So that's been a really satisfying job. And it'll be nice to just keep seeing her get better. Hopefully James will send me a few texts through with the data from the robot on her eating a bit more and gaining a bit of weight. That's been good. Good lass. Thanks for your help, guys.
No, thank you.
That's all right. I'll speak to you with an update then, James, and see how she's getting on. What are you doing?
Upwards, I hope, so.
Yeah. Right. We'll see you
brilliant.
Later.
Brilliant. Thank you very
bye
much.
Bye.
Cheers. Bye-bye. Incredibly happy we've got that sorted. Just keep a good eye on her now. Just keep looking and checking that hopefully she'll start eating and drinking. And yeah, that's all we can hope for now.
As James pointed out, a twisted stomach is a job that often requires two pairs of vet's hands.
I'm not quite as well-toned as he is, so I'm going to put my top on. Yeah, I can feel your hand.
Is that it there?
That's it. You've got it there. Are you happy now?
Yeah, can you just come and hang on to this while I get some suture in?
And working together can help vets get to know each other.
That'll be yours, Peter. That's all you drink, isn't it? I know you too well.
Well, you do, don't you?
Over the last 5 years,
1 minute past midnight, the phone rang with an emergency call. There you are, Matt. Merry Christmas.
That's definitely been the case for Huddersfield vets Matt and David.
I think most people see Matt as a big brother, sort of. If he was a dog, he'd be a Labrador. People like them, very friendly, slightly goofy. Is that offensive?
No, it's grand.
No, just, I mean, if you're enthusiastic.
I found big brother. Dave's little brother. Three words, loves his hair.
But David thinks Matt doesn't love his hair enough.
Nice to see you. All right, this is Matt. I do think it's important that you look smart. We are professionals after all. Right, let's get cracking, sort this out. He normally gets it cut in a bowl, and it's about time you had a proper haircut. You're a bit nervous, aren't you? I can tell. I'm really enjoying this, actually.
Look at that. I feel like I'm ready already. That's got a bomb looking at that.
Dave definitely takes care of his hair.
David's hair, he says it's not important to him, and he'll say it's not a thing, but everyone you speak to will say it is a thing apart from David.
I don't accept this.
Until you spend more time with him and you realise how much effort and care goes into creating such a do, you know, you don't fully appreciate it.
That's looking good.
Hi. I feel 5 years younger, Dave.
A whole new man.
Well, I feel much lighter. Some of the greys have gone, and I feel sleek and ready to get back out there.
See you later.
I really hope Matt can keep the quality of his hair up. Now it's sorted, let's try and stay on top of it.
Up on the North York Moors.
Come on! Come on!
Abby loves spending time with her flock.
Fizz. Hello, Fizz.
So in here, we have Fluffy, my massive, Emma, Loppy, they're my two mules. In here, we have Bethany and her twins. And in here, we have Coco, and she's got twins.
A few weeks ago, when one of Abby's mums-to-be was struggling, Peter performed an emergency C-section to try and save Fifi and her premature lambs.
Good girl.
Today, he's come to check on them.
No, Abby.
No, then.
But sadly, it's not good news.
I've lost all the lambs, though, but...
I did, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, well, one died on the way home, and then I kept one in the house to get it going.
But it just happened to be, had it?
No.
But you put your heart and soul into it.
Yeah.
I know when we were at the surgery, I could see how you were trying to revive her, and you gave it 100%. You can't do any more than that.
No.
That's lambing time, really. You win some, you lose some. But it's a bittersweet morning, really.
I'm glad she's all right.
She's doing OK?
Yeah, she's fine.
Did she eat OK?
She was off of food a bit, so I gave her some syrup. Next day, she's
like treacly stuff?
Yeah. It was syrup, two eggs.
That's an old-fashioned remedy over the years. Raw eggs and treacle.
Yeah.
It's surprising how many you can pull around with that. She's surviving, and not only is she surviving, she's thriving. And I think we can take those stitches out now, can't we? Right. She's healed up quite nicely as well. Do you know, I'm absolutely chuffed she's as bright as she is, really. I can see that she's been a big thing for you, Abby.
Yeah, I like my sheep, and I certainly think I'm going to stick with being a shepherd, because it just makes you have a feeling at lambing time. Watching the lambs spring about, it just puts a smile on your face.
Doesn't it? It's a magical time, and I love it. I think in years to come, this flock's going to get bigger and bigger and bigger. I might be wrong, but I don't think so.
I don't think you'll be wrong.
Anyway, nice to see you,
yeah,
Abby.
See you later.
And Peter's prediction about Abby's flock growing already seems to be a pretty safe bet.
Oh. A lamb's just been born, so I'm just making sure its airways are clear. And then now I'll let the mum lick it. I'm very proud of myself, really. I didn't think I could do farming, but as I'd grown up with it, I thought, well, I can. Like, everyone, you can adapt to things. Nothing should ever stop you. All these get treated like they're my own babies, even the mums. When I see these being born, it just makes me smile.
Saturday morning in Thirsk, where the promise of new life is about to make for a landmark day. At the practice, Julian and Anne have just opened.
Cotton wool.
Old friend and client Liz has just arrived with struggling, heavily pregnant basset hound Gina.
Come on, Gina. There's a good girl.
Poor thing.
There you go.
Gina, are you all right? She says, oh, Mum, what's going on? I'm supposed to have some babies, but nothing's happening.
Five months,
dumpling.
Huh?
Dumpling, that's a good word.
Come on, dumpling, we're going this way. Today is quite an exciting moment, really. We've got our very first surgical patient. So where is everything? It's always exciting doing a cesarean, isn't it?
But it is. It's one of the best ops, really, isn't it?
Especially when it's our very, very first operation in the practice. And hopefully one with a really happy outcome. In half an hour, we should have loads of squeaking, cute little puppies.
We're slightly running around not being able to find anything because the nurses have put everything away in a tidy fashion and now we can't find anything, but it's fine. I've got swabs.
And we've got clippers.
All right, scalpel.
Oh, scalpel.
This is when you need the nurses here and not just the whole load of vets. Come on then, Gina Dumpling.
Just hope everything goes to plan. We think we've got everything that we need in the right places, but we'll see, really.
It's not a very good vein, is it?
Good girl to go.
So she should be very soon drifting off to sleep.
Blimey, she's like a beached whale, poor thing.
I think there's going to be a lot in here. I reckon maybe even 10.
She's my little sweetheart. They're very vulnerable, aren't they, when they're like this, and I feel a bit sick.
The biggest problem with the size of her is the anaesthetic, actually, because she's not breathing very deeply. Well, she's quite light.
Missy's breathing a nice gas. She's huffing and puffing a bit.
She's not really taking big breaths, so that's the biggest problem.
Still to come.
Got this little stray kitten, and she's absolutely beautiful.
Peter thinks he knows the perfect place.
Hello.
For a homeless kitten.
I think I've found your new lodgings.
Three weeks ago at James Hill's dairy farm.
Come on, then. Good girl.
Shona performed life-saving stomach surgery after one of the herd's computerised collars flagged a major problem.
You all right, love, aren't you?
I'm just hoping that all is looking good today and we can get her signed off and she can live happily ever after. Hello.
Morning.
You're right, Oliver. Hello, superstar. Right, I'll have a look at the stitches then. You're girly, aren't you? You can tell it's not painful, so there's no sign of an infection in there or anything. There's not loads of excessive swelling, and she's not bothered when I'm feeling it, and it's not sore. So I think these stitches are ready to come out, really. She's looking really well. She's really bright in her head and happy looking. She has put a bit of weight on. She's filling out a bit, which we like to see. What's she weighing now?
660, I think. So,
oh, right. Yeah. So she's put nearly that 50 kilos back on then. Oh, brilliant. Yeah. I'm really, really pleased with her so far. You're a good girl, aren't you? Good loss.
That'll do.
All right, thank you.
Thank you.
See you next time. Yeah.
Cheers.
Bye.
Right. I'm happy today. That's
the best outcome you could hope for. So, yeah, I hope she goes on all right now, and just keep an eye on her. She keeps carrying on like this, we'll be all right. Come on then, sweetheart, come on. To the way. Come on.
I'm a big fan of cows. They're one of my favourite animals. They bring their own challenges, but when you can see one doing so well after surgery like this, then it's really satisfying.
A sad part of a vet's job is when they come across unwanted animals. But today, Peter has a plan.
Got this little stray kitten, and she's absolutely beautiful, but she needs a home, and I've been thinking, where can I rehome her? And then I had this light bulb moment, and I thought, I know just the place where this kitten's going to be very happy. Hello. I think I've found your new lodgings. Morning.
Morning, young man.
I've a young lady here wanting a new home, and I couldn't think of anywhere better.
Bring her in. Put light on.
That's it.
Oh, come on, little mouse. Oh, you're on your widget, but you're there.
I think she's very bonny, this little kitten.
Oh, she's gorgeous.
Do you think she'll fit in all right?
Oh, you fit in with the green clang, won't you? Home for waves and stress. Oh, she's gorgeous, Pete.
She's lovely.
After Peter's light bulb moment, Jean's had a bright idea herself.
Her name is Moonshine.
Moonshine?
You're going to stop here, aren't you, Moonshine? I want your spare door when she's ready.
Yeah, yes, we will. Let's just have a Jane. We'll just have a quick look at her. Let's have a look.
There you are. You take over.
Let's have a look at you.
Young man, you take over.
It's all right, aren't you?
He's having a look down your plug holes. See if there's any foreign bodies.
No. Not a creepy crawly inside. No here, mates. Beautiful. You've washed your ears, haven't you? Well, what we're going to have to do now, and you won't love me for this, but we'll have to pop a handkerchief in you. Ah, oh, she's well behaved, Jean. But I never whimpered, did you?
You didn't bat an eyelash, did
you? What a brave little kitten.
Come here.
Let's just check that. Yep.
We got her. Oh, he's got you now. Your Moonshine Green. You got what you see.
That's it. Just till she gets her bearings. That's lovely. She doesn't look too worried about it, does she? Man, none of your cats look worried about anything here.
Not here, no.
Anyway, I better go and get some more work done.
But thanks for bringing her.
You're welcome. I think she'll be a lovely addition.
We'll get her some toys.
I think this is a marriage made in heaven, really. It's a cat's paradise here, because they can either live in the house or they can live out in the buildings. But I think Moonshine, I think, will be spending a fair bit of time in front of that fire.
Peter's delivery came free of charge.
Peter?
Yes?
I've got a problem.
But Jean has other ideas.
I've fell in sweet shop.
You naughty girl.
And large tuppy dust.
Fair exchange is no robbery. Why, you are a temptress. You're very naughty. You're very naughty, you know.
I love you, see.
Across Thirsk, Julian and Anne are performing the first operation at their new practice.
So we're in.
They're trying to deliver Gina the Basset Hound's puppies.
There we are, pressure's off, heart rate's come down.
There we go, we're going to have some fun. What I don't want to do is mess up our lovely new floor. Come on, pop from you there, I can see you. There we go. Bad number one.
It's a boy.
Who's puppy?
The babies are already coming thick and fast.
This one might not be alive.
But Julian's fearing the worst for one that's covered in poo.
That pup's all stained with what's called meconium. I don't know whether it's no good.
Well, I'll give it a go.
Come on, green puppy. It's got a heartbeat, this one. You breathing, mister? I'm not quite sure how good that one is. Come on, puppy. Oh.
Ah. What's a good noise? God, there's more, look.
God, this is a bit frantic.
It's more frantic than usual, isn't it, this? Well, it's a good test run, isn't it? And there's lots of pups. Ah, look at that! Right, that's the last one.
That's the last one.
One of the puppies has been causing concern for Julian, Anne and their fellow director, Isabella.
This one is yellow and green because he's inhaled some meconium, which is the first poo of pups.
But she's happy with his progress.
He's doing fine, he's breathing, and the collar is turning better now, so... Aw, I know, sorry.
Well, what a mess in our new surgery.
First operation, and we've got puppy goo and blood and gubbins.
Spoiling our lovely colour scheme, isn't it? There's loads of puppies, as we knew there would be.
Five girls, three boys, I believe. She looked quite calm, although that might have just been because she didn't have the energy to get her butt tummy up off the floor.
When you were pregnant, you could hardly get off the ground, could you? Do you remember that?
I was walking up Sutton Bank the day before I had Jack, I'll have you know.
Well, we've finished our bit now. We'll give her a clean-up.
I think the next offer we do will be a lot more smooth, because we won't be running around peering in all the cupboards trying to find things.
Very successful, a very happy sight and a happy situation. So, yeah, it's been good today. Happy days.
And once Mum has recovered...
She's a lot less hairy than she was.
She's reunited with owner Liz and eight demanding babies.
Are they all content?
Yeah, they all seem brilliant.
It's amazing, isn't it? Like, what, an hour ago, they were all inside her, and now they're all there, drinking away.
Thank you very, very much.
No, it's been good.
Flowers for your new opening.
Excellent.
Oh, thank you, that's very kind.
Our first patient. First customer, a happy customer. She's wagging her tail, look, she wants to go in.
Well, thanks very much.
No problem, thank you
very much. I'm pleased you've come back to first.
So are we. See ya.
See you later.
Well, that went really well, apart from some minor confusion at the beginning where we couldn't work out where the cotton wool lived and the syringes and everything else. We soon found our feet, and it was nice to do such a happy procedure as our first procedure, and it's nice to see that we brought yet more life into the world in a really happy and fun way. For many people, Thirsk's the home of veterinary practice in the UK, possibly the world, and it's good to be back, and hopefully we'll do a good job of looking after the animals of Thirsk once again.
Catch more from the Yorkshire Vet new next Tuesday at 8. Tackling more clutter than ever before, Nick Knowles is back with some stunning transformations in his Big House clear out, new Thursday at 8. And tonight, where big is better and the cow is king, join farmers Rob and Dave for their big Texas rodeo, brand new next.